So pick me. Choose me. Love me.
For almost 15 years, Shonda Rhimes has been the queen of primetime TV.
It's handled.
From Grey's Anatomy to Scandal, How to Get Away with Murder to Station 19, Shonda and her eponymous production company, Shondaland, have been behind it all.
I'm content. I feel like I have done all the things that I wanted to do. I'm not out to prove anything.
But that doesn't mean she's slowing down. In 2017, Shonda signed a landmark deal with Netflix, and she's finally ready to spill some spoilers.
From what I've heard, 8 new shows in the works, perhaps more,
maybe more.
Another spoiler, the new shows are Shonda like we've never seen her before. No McSteamies, no McDreamies. Instead, on deck, a historical series called Bridgerton.
Talk about that one.
It's this beautiful, lush, amazing show that's set in Regency England, and we're filming it there right now.
Is this the one with Julie Andrews?
It is the one with Julie Andrews, which, come on.
Come on. When you're looking for writers or talent, is there a common thread that you see with the people you're attracted to?
I like people with opinions. I like people who are not afraid to argue or stand up for themselves, who have something to say that's original. Ooh. You know, that's not always easy to do, to stand up in a room and speak up for yourself. But I like people who have the courage to do that.
Shonda herself is no stranger to pushing boundaries.
One of the things I'm really proud of is getting to put these images out there so that young women can see different versions of themselves. You know, I always think about Scandal and Carrie having, you know, straight hair sometimes, or she wearing her natural hair sometimes, or Viola taking off that wig, which was Viola's idea and was amazing. You want people who have no connection to that at all to look and realize that professional women can look all kinds of ways.
For Shonda, her work imitates her life. In partnership with the beauty brand Dove, she is called their chief storyteller, a role where she aims to help empower girls and women by telling real stories, encouraging diversity, and challenging those traditional beauty stereotypes.
Everywhere except for New York and California, it's still legal to discriminate against somebody for wearing their hair the way it's culturally, naturally, the way you're born with it.
Sure.
We're talking about how it affects people's self-esteem to be told that their hair is not appropriate.
It's true. It's deeply personal to me. I was picking up my daughter, I think she was 7 or 6 at the time, from school. And she was like, Mom, I want a ponytail. I want a swingy ponytail.
Mm.
And I was like, what? And I'm thinking all the books, yeah, and people around you in diverse classrooms. Like, I've done everything I could do, right? And so now every holiday, every spring break, you know, we take pictures. I post it on Instagram of us twisting our hair. And I mean, it really matters.
My daughter, who's 7, often is saying, like, why isn't my hair longer? Why isn't my hair doing this? And finally, one day, I was showing her all these pictures of women with afros.
Me too.
And she started wearing an afro, and now she tells me that she's a fashion model. If you see it and you think, oh, that looks cute, or they're sort of being celebrated, then you feel like it matters. And I think if you never see it, it never feels okay.
For all the roles Shonda inhabits in her writing and her work, motherhood may be the one she is most candid about.
If I am succeeding in one area, I am failing in another in a lot of ways. Like, it's very hard to have any balance when you are mothering. You can't keep all the balls in the air at the same time. You are always dropping a ball. And that is the reality, and the thing that people have to do is to stop beating themselves up about it.
Do they have a bug? Do they like to write?
Oh, God, no, I hope not. One of them wants to be an astronaut, one of them wants to be a scientist, and my oldest doesn't know yet.
Oh!
Yeah.
So you don't want them to go into this?
I really want them to be who they are. I feel like what my success allows is for them to get to pursue whatever dream that they want to have.
And in typical Shonda style, she never leaves an audience without a good old-fashioned jaw dropper.
What do they watch?
My children don't get to watch television.
Really?
Not much, no.
I'm shocked. I'm not usually speechless. Tell me about that.
Here's my secret. When I do let them watch television these days, right now, what I do is I've taken one of my Netflix channels. Thank you, Netflix. I've changed the audio to French. I told them that if they watch Netflix, they can watch it in French.
Shut.
So they watch Captain Underpants in French, which they seem to like. My whole thing is, if you're gonna watch television, you might as well be learning another language.
Wow.
And so they are. So it's working.
Mastering TV time is clearly her strength, as she has shown throughout her career, including that deal with Netflix, rumored to be worth $150 million.
When you signed that deal, was it a pinch me moment?
What's great about it was just the feeling of accomplishment, a feeling of being done, a feeling of the finish line to cross in a way, or maybe a starting line to cross.
Have you exhaled?
Oh, I don't know if that'll ever happen.